Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Hannah. If you guys are new here, I do beauty reviews, unboxings, and makeup tutorials on this channel. And for today's video, we are going to be doing a review of Selena Gomez's new makeup line called Rare Beauty. It's actually sold at Sephora. I ordered a few products and they are here. I know I'm a little late on this video, but your girl, we're a small channel over here, so we don't get PR like all the big beauty gurus or anything, and I ordered it online, so it did take a little bit of time to ship, especially over the holiday weekend. But without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the video. So the items I picked up for the launch of Rare Beauty, I went ahead and got the Soft Pinch Blush Liquid Matte, and this is their liquid blush, and I got it in the shade Love. So this is what it looks like when you pop it out. So that is what the blush looks like. It is this really pretty, like burnt red almost, kind of like a pinky orangish red. That's like the best way I can describe it. And this top part feels very nice. It's not super plasticky. I mean, I'm sure it is maybe plastic, but it doesn't feel like cheap plastic. And it just has this little ball on top so you can turn it. And there is the wand for the blush. So I'm just gonna go ahead and swatch the color for you guys. I did see that it's really pigmented, at least from what I've seen on the other reviews from beauty gurus. So this is what the shade looks like initially. And I'm just gonna go ahead and buff that in. It's very, very soft. Oh, wow. That is what it looks like with just like a little bit of rubbing in. And this is what it looks like. I'm just gonna blend it down my hand a little bit. And that's what it looks like a little bit more blended in down my hand a little bit. So as you guys can see, it's very blendable, super soft. It doesn't really feel like anything's on my hand. It's not super sticky. And I believe this is the matte version. Yeah, so I think she came out with two mattes and two like normal finishes. Like more of like a dewy natural finish. And these blushes are retailing for $20 a piece. She came out with four total shades. Two were like natural finish, more like glossy. And then the other two, one of which I have, are the matte versions. So this was $20. The other item I picked up was the Always an Optimist Base Illuminatrice. It's just like an illuminating primer base. Let me go ahead and open this up and show you guys. This item was, I got the mini and it was $14. I wanted to make sure I liked it before I bought the full size. This is giving me very Fenty vibes. So this packaging actually reminds me a lot of the Fenty line, kind of like that frosted material on the outside and then the cap. It just reminds me a lot of that, but the part that I haven't seen before, at least in like most other packagings, is the actual component that it comes in. This is more of like a, it's like a textured box that it's in, almost like a fabric-y like tweed material, like when you feel cloth, how there's like the ridges and like the squares in it. I don't know, maybe, I don't know if the camera will pick it up, but even though the box isn't something that I usually care about, I do really like the feeling of this. It feels very luxury and not cheap. So it kind of, it helps me bear the price a little bit because it isn't necessarily like a luxury brand. It's something that we haven't really seen before. I feel like it kind of reminds me of the Fenty launch when people were like, oh my God, like, I don't know if I want to spend the money on Fenty. I feel like it's kind of the same thing. Like, do I want to spend the money on Selena Gomez's makeup line? Like, is it going to be good? What's the quality going to be like? But so far, packaging and that swatch that I just did, I really enjoy it. Let me go ahead and do a swatch of the primer because it is an illuminating one. I'm just going to do like a small little. So this is what it looks like just on my hand. And I'm just going to go ahead and smooth it in. It feels a lot like a moisturizer and it definitely has that kind of illuminating effect on it without it being like super in your face. It's not like a liquid highlighter that you put on before and you kind of use that as your base to get an illuminating effect. This is much more natural and kind of more dewy. So I really like that. The last item that I went ahead and picked up was the Rare Beauty Lip Soufflé Cream à la Verre Matte. This is in the shade Brave. That's just kind of what the packaging looks like. Once again, it's kind of that like tweed, clothy feel-like material. I don't really know how to explain it, but it's really nice packaging. So this packaging of the, I guess you would call it the matte lip cream, this kind of reminds me of like the Fenty packaging, X, like the KKW packaging of like the, I don't know if they're the nude sticks. I haven't tried any of Kim's makeup, but it kind of reminds me of like the packaging pictures I've seen of this. But let's go ahead and give it a swatch. I don't know why I just shook it. I saw in some of the reviews that in her foundation, it has like the metal ball in it. So you're supposed to shake the foundation. So I wondered if there was like, okay, no. So it's just in the foundation. I was like testing it out with the blush and the liquid lip. I don't know why. So let me go ahead and put this on for you guys. So it's definitely not like an actual liquid lip. It says it's a matte lip cream. It's definitely more so like a cream. So this is definitely more of like the lip cream as the name implies. It's not really like a liquid lip. Obviously you can still see some of my skin peeking through on this. It does actually remind me a lot of the Kylie Jenner lip blushes. I reviewed that in one of my Kylie Cosmetics videos. I want to say it was the Stormy collection. I tried out one of the lip blush formulas and I really liked it. It was very natural. So I think that I'm going to like this too because it feels very similar. These Lip Soufflé Matte Lip Creams were actually $20. So it's pretty comparable to like the Kylie Jenner lipsticks, the Fenty, kind of like those influencer-esque celebrity makeup lines that come out that aren't necessarily like a luxury like Laura Mercier or YSL or things like that, but they're not drugstore either. So I feel like these prices are very comparable to what other influencers and celebrities are putting out. I also went ahead and used a code on Sephora's website. It was just Rare Beauty, R-A-R-E-B-E-A-U-T-Y, Rare Beauty. And you use that in the promo codes when you go to check out at Sephora. And you get a free little liquid blush. This is in the shade Grace, which is the other matte one. Look at how tiny it is. It's just a little bitty baby. Let me go ahead and do a little swatch for you guys. It's definitely gonna be a little swatch. I do appreciate though, even though it's like a sample size, it still comes with a nice cap and it still has a doe foot applicator rather than like making us like squeeze it out of like a packet or something. Okay. This is like almost like a magenta purpley pink. So this is Grace. That's the color that I just tested out. That was the sample. And then the other one that's right here is Love. And that's the one that I bought in full size. And these are both the matte versions. I'm gonna go ahead and rub this in just to see what this looks like on its own. This is what it looks like all rubbed in. The other samples I got with my purchase, these were just general Sephora samples. I went ahead and picked up the Briogeo Scalp Revival. This is just a micro exfoliating shampoo, and I also went ahead and got the YSL blurring primer. I've never used a YSL product before because they're insanely expensive, but might as well get a taste of the bougie life, even if it is in a foil packet. But the other item I picked up from Sephora while I was checking out was actually the Too Faced Milk Chocolate Soleil Bronzer. This is something that a lot of YouTubers talk about, makeup artists, they say it's really good, really blendable, smells like chocolate. I just got this in the matte version, and this is, like I said, milk chocolate. I'm like really pale, so I got the lightest one. So this is what the packaging looks like. And it smells like hot chocolate, dead on. So that is the last item I picked up from there. And they actually were having this on sale along with some other products. They were like 50% off. So I ended up getting this for $16. I think usually it's like $32. Because I think it was like 50% off. So I got it while it was on sale. I think they were doing it to compete with Ulta because they were doing their 21 Days of Beauty at the time. So I think that they just had like a lot of products severely discounted to kind of compete with that. But those were all the items I picked up from Sephora. Let's go ahead and hop into the review of Rare Beauty. I'm going to go ahead and start out with the Rare Beauty Illuminating Primer. I'm just going to go ahead and pump a little bit of that onto my... Oh, we're not an ASMR channel, I promise. Okay, let's see. It feels just like a moisturizer. I feel like it's moisturizing my skin, but also illuminating it. Just gonna go ahead and get a little bit under the eyes. And it doesn't dry down super fast either. Like, it's very easy to maneuver and blend into the skin. And it's not silicone-y either. Like, I've used the silicone primer. Like, it's silicone-feeling primer, and this is not that. So I really like this. I'm gonna go ahead and let this set, and I'll be right back. So I've let the primer kind of set in a little bit. It did kind of leave, like, it looks like a little oily on me. I do have combination skin, so maybe this would be better for somebody with like dry to maybe combo. I think it depends on your preference. I'm not usually a super dewy person. I kind of like it to be more either like natural finish to like matte. And this is definitely more dewy to natural depending on your skin type. But let me go ahead and apply my foundation. We'll go ahead and speed it up while we do it, and then we'll see how the foundation sticks to this primer. I'm gonna be using the Estee Lauder Double Wear foundation. I've been using this a few times recently, or I've been using this a lot recently, so I'll be able to tell whether or not this is a primer I'm gonna enjoy with my other foundations. As you guys can see, it definitely brought like illumination like through my foundation. This foundation isn't necessarily illuminating. It's kind of like a Your Skin but better to matte. It's more of like that natural finish that maybe leans a little bit towards matte depending on the skin type. But this definitely just made it look more like my skin but better. It kind of toned down, my foundation toned down the illumination of the primer, but it still is able to peek through, making it look a little bit more natural and like glowy rather than like oily and gross. So far, so good on the primer. I'm gonna go ahead and pop some blush on. Like I said, this is in a doe foot applicator, so I'm just going to put a little bit on my cheeks. I'm only gonna put a dot because from all of the videos I've seen, it is so pigmented. Okay. And then we can always put more on, but I think this will be fine.
I apologize.
what the blush looks like. Definitely a very natural finish, and as you guys can see, that one dot went a really long way, and I actually blended up a little bit too far. So I'm just going to take a teensy bit of my concealer. I'm going to use the Tarte Shape Tape. I'm just going to put like literally a teensy drop right there, just blending it out with my finger, just because I went way too high with that blush. Alright guys, I'm going to go ahead and do the rest of my makeup off camera, and then we'll come back for the lips and our final thoughts. And I apologize if there's any background noise going on. I do live in a dorm and I am the RA, so I constantly have people running around the halls that are my residents. So just be aware of that. But I am actually going to go ahead and bronze on camera with you guys. This is because it's the new one that I haven't tried before, the Too Faced Milk Chocolate Matte. I'm just going to go ahead and take, I'm just going to go ahead and take my Eco Tools brush. It's called a base buffer. I think you really can, it's a really good brush to use for foundation, but I also like it for bronzer. Ooh. Okay, so I really like the bronzer, even though that's unrelated to Rare Beauty, but I really like it. So I don't care. Okay, the last item that I have to test out for Rare Beauty is the matte lip cream. Let's go ahead. I'm gonna try to do it without a lip liner. I usually don't use lip liners. Okay, so that is what it looks like on the lips. That is only one dunk of product. Let me get my hair out of my face. So that's only one dunk of product. It is a really nice color. It's not super matte, obviously. Like, it looks matte in color, but it's not matte, like a matte formula where it kind of makes your lips like crusty and like it sinks into their cracks or anything. And it's actually got really good coverage. When I did that swatch on my hand, I saw a lot of skin peeking through, but on the lips, it looks more like a lipstick rather than like a like lip blush, which is like the formula I would describe this as. And I think I actually saw another YouTuber like put it on her finger and then kind of like dab it in, just kind of give like a nice flush on the lips. And I think that would look really nice too. But I really like this color. It matches my shirt really nicely. It goes along with that kind of this fall vibe we have going on. But I think that's everything. That's all the products I tried out. Let me go ahead and do a quick recap for you guys. This is the Mini Illuminating Primer. I really like this. It just gives a nice healthy glow to the skin underneath of a foundation. If you are super oily though, maybe this isn't for you unless you're using a matte foundation. But honestly, I really like it and I'm excited to continue to use it. The Rare Beauty Matte Lip Cream, that's what it was called. I really like this. Definitely more like a lip blush. Super nice on the lips, very hydrating. Really love it. Probably pick this up in a few more colors. Honestly, I love it that much. Then the liquid blushes. I do really like these. It was really easy to blend. I would say it's very comparable to the Glossier, I think they're called cloud paints. I have two of those. I would say the formula is really similar to that. I do really like it. It gives a nice flush to the cheeks and it is very buildable, and I can get light, like super light color or like really pigmented color. So I do really like it in that sense. Do I think that I would probably repurchase this in more colors? Probably not. I do use blush quite a bit, but I kind of stick to like the same like few colors. So now that I have this one and then my two cloud paints, I probably won't pick up more colors in this. I'll probably pick up another color in the matte lip cream. I don't know why I can't remember the name of it. I'll probably pick up another color in the matte lip cream just because I really like the formula. It's very natural, super easy to wear. And then once I went out of this, I'll probably go ahead and pick up a full size. So was Selena Gomez's Rare Beauty line worth the hype? I would say yeah, it's super natural and just easy. Like, I just think it just looks really nice on the skin, really nice on the lips. I think it's definitely one of those lines that you could wear, like, on an everyday basis without it looking too too done up, if that makes sense. More like an everyday line rather than a, hey, I'm going to a party tonight, or I'm going to a wedding. Like, let me look super nice, done up, like, slayed, like, whatever you want to call it. I think this is, like, your everyday, like, kind of girl next door line. It's just super easy and casual. So if that's you, go ahead and go to Sephora, pick it up, use that code I was telling you about, Rare Beauty, to get a free little lip, or a free little liquid blush. I would definitely go ahead and do that. But thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. And other than that, I hope you guys have a great day. Bye.